Now Sri Vijay Sai Reddy.
Mic is not on, sir.
On, it is on. It is on. Vijay Sai Reddy, mic. Let the mic be on.
No.
It's on.
You are not sitting in your seat?
No, it's on.
Yeah, it's on, sir. Yes, sir.
Surinder Nagar Ara.
Surendra Singh Sagar, you are not sitting in the seat. Is it your seat?
That's his seat.
Yeah, it's my seat, sir.
Okay, then you speak.
Sanjay's seat is coming now.
Yes.
Okay.
Now it's right.
Now it's right.
Yes. Honorable Deputy Chairman, sir. I, on behalf of my party, raise to support this bill moved by the Honorable HRD Minister. This bill, by moving this bill, Honorable HRD Minister is contemplating to give a legal backing for the institution, academic institution, which the Government of India has started in a private premises about 2 years back, 1 year back, and this is the second academic year that is going on. Sir, according to the minister, there are about 37 such national institutes in India. But the research reports say that there are only 31 institutions, and this is the 32nd institute which the bill is seeking to contemplate to set up. Sir, there are few points relating to this bill. I would like to bring it to the notice of the Honorable Minister. And these anomalies, I am very confident that the Honorable Minister will address them. First, point number
but
one, sir.
I want to tell you in advance, your time is only 3 minutes, but I can
sir,
extend up to 5 minutes.
Please give me 5 minutes,
sir. 5 minutes I will give.
I'll confine myself only to
in
the
5 bill. Minutes. Do
I'll
that,
not,
do that.
I'll not go beyond that, sir. Sir, the first point is that student-teacher ratio. As of now, the student to teacher ratio is 1:23, whereas the stipulated ratio is 1:12. I request the Honorable Minister to ensure that the student teacher ratio is complied with, because these institutions are of national importance. Sir, there is a necessity to add more number of institutes in this country. It is not only in Andhra Pradesh, but even in other states also, every other state also, these institutes are necessarily to be established, because according to the reports available, there are about 12 lakh students every year appear for examination for AIEEE, All India Engineering Entrance Examination. As against the 12 lakh students who appear, the seats that are available as of now, according to the information available with me, in respect of these 31 institutes, is only both IITs and also NITs together, approximately about 28,000. So to say precisely, in so far as NITs are concerned, it is 16,810, and so far as IITs are concerned, it is 11,000, put together altogether about 28,000 seats. Where is 12 lakh students? Therefore, there is every necessity in this country to establish more such institutes and make the education more standardized. Sir, to satisfy the requirement as stipulated in Schedule 13 of Andhra Pradesh Reorganization Bill, the Government of India has started this institution without any basic proper infrastructure in somewhere in West Godavari district, wherever it is. My only point is, when we establish such institutions of highest standard, we need to ensure that proper infrastructure is provided. Proper infrastructure in the sense, there has to be land, buildings, labs, and what not, everything. Therefore, the standards of the institutions can be maintained. Sir, coming to the budgetary allocation that has been granted to this NIT, not only this NIT, in the budget of 2015 and 16, I can confidently say, because the figures are available with me, for IIT and NIT and IISER, 40 crores for each of the institution has been granted in 2015-16 budget. Similarly, for Central University, for Tribal University, for Petroleum University, there are only about 1 crore, 2 crore, a meager grant has been sanctioned in the budget 2015-16. My only point, even in 2016-17, latest budget also, more or less similar sanctions have been given. If this is the path which Government of India is adopting, and this is the pace with which the Government of India is going and making the budgetary allocations year after year, how many years it will take for Government of India to complete the project? Because for each of such institute, it is required to invest at least about 1,200 to 1,500 crores for each of such institutions of national importance. Sir, therefore, I request the Honorable Minister to make the budgetary allocations, appropriate budgetary allocations, and ensure that all the projects what have been envisaged and promised in as early as possible. Two more points, sir. Sir, coming to the reservations for locals, in this institute, 50% of the seats would be allocated to non-locals. That's the criteria. The students have been demanding everywhere that at least 85% of the seats should be allocated to the local students. So this has to be adhered to, because I can give you one example, sir. I'll quickly complete.
No time for example.
In the case of MCI and through NEET, 15% of the states, 15% of the seats from each of the states would be pooled and given to the non-locals. If that is the criteria, that is the yardstick which is followed in that case, why not in the case of NIT also? Therefore, okay. I request the Honorable HRD Minister to consider all these points and take an appropriate decision, sir.
Okay.
We support the bill, we welcome the bill, sir.
Thank you, Sri Anil.